Hello and welcome to this edition of Inside Petaluma. This time we're right next to Petaluma High School at the Petaluma Wildlife Museum. And I know you might be thinking, boring. No. This is really different, and it's one of the only ones we're aware of in the world, certainly in the country, that does what it does. What's that mean? Well, let's go inside and find out. We are inside the Petaluma Wildlife and Natural History Museum with Neil Ramos, who is the director, not the polar bear, this guy right here. Did I get the name right?
It's the Petaluma Wildlife and Natural Science Museum.
Okay. So this is my first time here, and I guess every grade school kid in Petaluma pretty much has been through here, but adults, myself included, a lot of us haven't been in here, so this is amazing, and we're just starting here at the outside. Tell me what's going on here, just kind of a broad overview.
Sure. The Petaluma Wildlife Museum is a wildlife museum operated and maintained and developed by high school students, and we're actually located on the campus of Petaluma High School.
And stop right there, because I understand, as far as you know, it's the only museum operated by high school students in the country.
There are a few across the country operated by high school students, but we are certainly the only wildlife museum, and we're among the biggest and largest.
And all the kids come in here and do what?
Our high school students basically take a class through Petaluma High School in which they learn how to maintain, operate, and develop a wildlife museum. And then they come every single day and they take care of our 9,000 square foot facility.
Well, let's talk about Hugh Cotting real quick.
Yes.
Because that's a big reason this thing even exists. So
exactly.
Tell me a little bit about him. Santa Rosa?
Yeah, Hugh Cotting is the founder of Cotting Enterprises in Santa Rosa, commercial real estate developer. He owns Cotting Town Mall and the Montgomery Village, and among many other properties. Throughout his life, he was always a big game hunter. He actually had his own personal museum in Santa Rosa until about the mid-80s. He decided to close it for one reason or another, and when he did, an instructor at Petaluma High School named Ron Head contacted him and asked him if he could borrow some of his taxidermy mounts, and these are taxidermy mounts. He was going to use it for his wildlife classes for education, and when he contacted Mr. Cotting, he said, well, I'll tell you what, I'll give you the whole collection. And Mr. Head said, sure, I would love to take it, but we don't really have a place to put a $1 million collection. So Mr. Cotting graciously said, I'll give you the money to find a place.
We're in the North American exhibit room, and this rivals anything you'd see at really any museum. You know, I remember as a kid going to Golden Gate Park, and it reminds me of going through the Natural History Museum there.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me about this room. This is an example of all the animals we'd find in Petaluma and a little bit farther out.
Exactly. We use this room to educate children about the animals they might find in their local continent, which is obviously North America. So this room, in order to show all the biodiversity in North America, is organized by elevation. It starts in the low elevation and works its way up. All the animals and the species are placed in that habitat where they might be found naturally.
But what I really like about this room is just the way it's built and making it look like they're in their natural habitat and how it was built. I think that's a neat story. Tell me about that.
Exactly. Well, when it was built in the early 90s, basically it was all community members that helped construct the entire museum. They volunteered their time, they volunteered their money, their resources, and they came in after work, after school, before work, before school, and they worked until the wee hours of the morning constructing mountains in North America in a building in Petaluma.
It's like the work that Disney would do building their sets when you're going through some of the...
Exactly.
I mean, they really did a great job.
Yeah.
Tell me about the tours real quick. I know it's mostly kids, and like I mentioned earlier, pretty much every grade school kid in Petaluma has been through here, and what do they get out of this tour?
Well, basically, if you're a elementary school child in Petaluma, you most likely will come to our facility and take a tour. We give tours to about 9,000 children a year. Those grades usually are about second to third grade is a good grade. They come in, they come through an entire hour and a half program in which our high school students show them and interpret the entire museum for them. They teach them about all sorts of things, biodiversity, camouflage, food webs, forestry, fossils, everything. They go through the whole thing, and it's all based on science standards for California.
All right, now we're in the Africa Hall, and another incredible room. I especially like the elephant busting out of the wall. Tell me about the artwork that got that thing together.
Yeah, that's our African elephant. It's a full taxidermy head. It comes emerging out of the mural. All these murals were painted by airbrush. There was no painting on them. Missouri Wildlife Foundation graciously supported us to repaint all of our displays about 5 years ago. The entire museum has been repainted.
And what's the basic idea that a kid will get after he leaves here? What's he going to learn that he didn't know before he walked in?
So our students, we attract them with the animals and with the giant taxidermy mounds and all this really cool stuff. But once they get here, they gain that appreciation for wildlife, and they also gain appreciation for how the real world works. We don't tell students what to do. We show them. We have them do it. They gain leadership skills. They gain communication skills. They gain organizational skills. They gain all these vocational abilities that will help them succeed in the real world, and they go on to succeed.
Now we're in the natural science room, and by the way, we haven't even gone through all of the rooms in this place, so that's part of the tease to get you to come down and check it out yourself. And we have our little friend here. Who is this?
This is London. He's our California desert tortoise. He's actually an endangered species in California. You can't have these as pets. And that's actually the reason why we have London. He was somebody's pet, and they weren't supposed to have him. And when he was confiscated, he came to live at the museum for the rest of his life.
And he's just one of many, many live animals here, so it's not all stuffed heads. So tell me about the live animals and how important they are to helping kids understand what's going on.
We have about 100 live animals representing about 50 species. Most of our animals are reptiles, just because they're easy to take care of for high school students, and they're also less permitting. They are also very interesting and very cute, and a lot of our students really appreciate learning how to take care of them and working with them.
So for funding and to keep this thing alive, what can people do? What are the needs?
Yeah, the museum is its own nonprofit, 501c3 nonprofit. We operate near the high school or with the high school in conjunction. We're a partnership. But they don't provide any direct funding. We're in charge of finding all of our own funding. And we do, but we are always appreciative of a little bit of help.
Okay, Neil, thank you so much.
No problem.
Neil Ramos here at the Petaluma Wildlife Museum. And thank you, London, for helping out. And we'll see you on the next time on Inside Petaluma. Awimawa, 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 awimawa.